Now, your stories, your struggles, and your successes. This is Focus on South Florida.
Welcome back, everyone. It's been said if you build it, they will come. That certainly has proven true for the Sun Trolley, an alternative mode of transportation that thousands of people in Broward County are using. The Sun Trolley began as a people mover in 1991, but with its most recent expansions, it's actually proving to be a lifeline for some people, and it might help you out. So that's why we're sharing it with you today. Joining me now to talk about these exciting upgrades is the Sun Trolley's executive director, Patricia Zeiler. Thank you so much for coming in, and we really wanted to focus on this because when you deal with the elderly or you deal with folks that maybe, you know, just don't have transportation, we're talking that this trolley now, you've developed routes that really can take them to hospitals and critical offices. Tell us about the expansion.
Well, the latest expansion is our Northwest Community Link. It's a neighborhood link that's basically the northwest section of the Fort Lauderdale is now connected to Department of Children and Families, healthcare, libraries, educational centers, you know, so folks in a community can get to basic services without having to drive a car, or if they don't have a car, it connects them.
How did you hear the crying need for this?
Well, actually this route was about to be eliminated. It had been funded by the Housing Authority of the City of Fort Lauderdale, and they were not able to fund any longer. We picked it up and managed to put together a funding package to keep it going and expanded it down into a little corner of the city called Melrose Park that had not had any services at all before.
And what kind of difference does this make in people's lives that you've seen?
Well, I mean, I ride the trolleys,
yes,
and talk to the folks. So, for example, one girl on that Northwest Link, she's taking care of elderly parents and children. She's a single mom.
Yes.
She just came off of assistance. She's managing to get to Department of Children and Families for her children, you know, for services there.
Because otherwise, I mean, you really can be at a loss to hold a job down, do things that you need to do, and goodness, if you need medical care.
In South Florida, especially,
yeah.
Yes. Yeah, because, I mean, lots of big cities up north have more sophisticated transit systems,
yes,
that folks can do without a car, but
yes,
unfortunately in South Florida, we're still building that infrastructure to make that connection for folks.
What still is the need area? If you had your wish list, and I know even funding for what you've got going now, you're looking for alternative funding, it's tough.
Absolutely.
What's the wish list?
Probably in my little corner of the universe that I work in, we have funding in place to just begin our WAVE project in the city of Fort Lauderdale. That's an in-ground streetcar that will move around, a people mover in the downtown.
Okay.
And then Sun Trolley will be its spokes, connecting other transit hubs to that WAVE project so that folks can move about the city of Fort Lauderdale without having to use a car. That's our wish list coming up.
And when do you think that could even happen?
The WAVE streetcar looks like probably about 2016. The other really important pieces we have, and this affects Miami-Dade too, the All Aboard Florida program with the FEC and mm-hmm. high-speed connection to Orlando is coming through our downtowns hopefully by 2015.
All right,
that's
something to look forward to there.
Yes.
In terms of numbers now, because I remember, you know, years ago when the people mover in Miami-Dade first started and we often talked about, is there anybody on that? You know, what are we looking at in terms of, riders in Broward County?
Well, Broward County, I mean, in our system right now, we just jumped in January up to over 41,000 folks moved a month.
Is that a good number?
It's a good number.
It's a good number.
For community,
okay,
bus, it's terrific.
Okay.
Hopefully our WAVE project, in addition to connecting the communities to the WAVE, the huge part of the downtown with a need for downtown offices to make connections to government centers and courthouses, and that would eliminate some of that street traffic. I was most struck by the earlier segment with the Mothers Against Drug Driving.
Yes.
Because part of the problem with that is the congestion on our streets,
yes,
and not having really safe pedestrian passages. That's a really huge piece of transit that all of our cities are looking at now, making our streets more pedestrian friendly so it's safer for everyone. Bicycles,
yes,
pedestrians, and especially folks who have special needs that, you know, can't cross the street as fast as you or I.
No, you're so right, and I know we were all talking with the moms and the Mothers of Drunk Driving together offset, and you were so moved by it,
yes,
and you're so right, because we're trying to look at, you know, these urban settings, but make them safe for pedestrians and also make them more green, which is also part of not having all the cars coming
in. Exactly. Exactly, because in addition to cars just adding congestion to the area, it's the carbon emissions. We run a biodiesel fleet, so it's a cleaner fleet.
Yes.
You know, a carbon's emission of cars in a downtown area can actually make the air difficult to breathe and not safe for some people.
Yeah.
So that's an important piece too.
And one of the things, always trying to come up with ideas to help. We talked about, you know, the elderly, that sometimes it's tough for them. You know, my mom visits here. Yes. She's a snowbird and she's not a driver, because a lot of New Yorkers aren't. But even going on the trolleys, a lot of times there's those big steps up. So we came up with a suggestion, right, about they need to develop stairs that automatically fall out.
Right, right.
I think that would help a lot of people.
There actually is some low rider technology that's unfortunately been pulled from TRIPS contracts because it's not meeting FTA standards.
Okay.
So it's something we got to work on.
Yes,
absolutely.
We got to do that for the moms and pops out there.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you, because I know that you are providing a lifeline for so many people, and we'll follow you along. We hope the expansion continues.
Thank you very much.
Have a great Sunday morning. Thanks for joining us. And thank